It's like a werewolf, only a panther.
A werepanther.
The werepanthers we have to look at as more of an endangered species. They remain isolated in their weird little community of Hotshot.
It's a really twisted backwoods kind of place. They're just kind of feisty, raw, just really rough, you know, gruff people. Very animalistic.
And they don't go out. They really don't go out into the human world very much at all.
Werepanthers, their tribe is actually sort of dying out. They're lacking a male figure that has sort of virility to obviously extend the family tree.
This group of werepanthers who live in Hotshot are deeply inbred.
So that leaves us on the short end of the stick then, don't it?
So that can account for their lack of intelligence, sophistication.
Whoa, 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 whoa. At least let me put it on the stove.
Wait, never got a stick before.
Motor skills.
Luther, come here. I said come here.
So they stumble across Jason, they kidnap him.
The ice box ain't cold or nothing.
I'm gonna have to replace the cooling element. Oh!
Save our people from going extinct.
They line up all the village women to have sex with Jason.
You're the best I ever had.
Next!
To sort of make him the ghost daddy of this particular tribe.
When ghost daddy mama was still alive, panthers was kings of the nature world.
In the lore of the werepanthers, Ghost Daddy and Ghost Mama were the first.
That was the beginning of our kind.
They're the Adam and Eve.
One man, one woman.
If you're gonna kill me now.
We ain't gonna kill you.
We gonna make a baby, you and me.
The elders of the tribe are convinced that Jason is the one.
If we wanna be sure we're gonna make us a panther, we gotta make you one of us first.
And on the next full moon, he's going to turn into a werepanther himself.
Next full moon, he'll be saying goodbye to what little piece of man's left in him.